It's simple time and this is Chef Tatong and today magluluto tayo ng lumpiang sariwa ba yun ang gusto natin? Kaya let's start cooking!
Simple, simple! Luto na ha!
This recipe is part of the Simple Cookbook series where we try to make cooking as simple as ABC. And we will start by making our crepes, a very tender crepes na to wrap our lumpia. And the important thing about this ay dapat hindi siya madaling matear, kaya very important na maganda yung recipe niya. So sisimulan natin. So I will start off with my dry ingredients. So meron akong combination of flour and cornstarch. 1/4 flour, 1/4 cornstarch. Lalagay ko din yung aking sugar. That's around 2 tablespoons of sugar. Meron akong salt, 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And I will just sift that. So, dapat yung flour natin is sifted para alam natin walang lumps. Yan, may malaking lumps. I'll just discard that. And yung gagawin natin dito ay ihahalo din natin yung ating wet ingredients. So, what do we have? 4 eggs. 1 cup of milk, so yung gamit natin dito, fresh milk, and also use water. And Golden Fiesta canola oil. And we just combine, beat it. Make a well, and we add it to our flour mixture. Yan. Careful, before adding more, we make sure that walang lumps. So it's a very light batter. So, diba, parang gumagawa ka lang ng pancake. And we strain it again. We use an 8 to 9 inch non-stick pan. So, I'm using a pan from Masflex today. And the key is, iinitin ko fully yung aking pan to make sure that it's really dry. No? Then, I turn down the heat and I get, just a drop of oil. Konting-konting oil lang siya. And I just wipe it. No? With a kitchen towel, just to spread it around. Yan. So that's how I start my cooking. And my pan is ready. The heat is on low. And you have to be sure na it's not too hot. Kasi if your pan is too hot, paglagay mo dito, magbabubble siya. We don't want that to happen. We want to have a very smooth na crepe. So I get 1/4 measure. Yan. And put it away from the fire a little bit just to, control the heat and pour. Yan. Kasi, if I put it and it's really hot, it's very hot, magbabubble tong aking crepe. Hindi magiging pretty yung aking crepe. And look at that, no? It dries out immediately. And I just leave it until yung edges niya will peel off. You will notice that little by little, the edges will peel off. And you know it's cooked. As long as dry na yung crepe sa taas, ibig sabihin, luto na siya. Yan. That's good enough. And we just transfer it into a plate. Flip natin. And yan. Look at that, no? So, may isang crepe na tayo. So, pag mainit pa siya, medyo very delicate siya. So, we have to allow it to cool. And yung gagawin natin, meron akong piece of paper dito, wax paper. I just put it in between layers para hindi ako mahirapan. And that's fine for now. Let's proceed with our, of course, our palaman. So, gagamit tayo ng ubod for our filling. Yan. And what is ubod? Ubod is the center ng heart of the coconut palm. So, ito siya, very important, pag pumili ka dito sa market, dapat piliin mo yung malambot at hindi pa mahibla. Hindi pa siya fibrous. And when you cut it across the grain. So, nakikita mo fibers, ganyan, yung grano. You cut across the grain. Huwag mong i-cut na sabay sa grain para when you bite into it, tender siya. And ito siya, pinakuluan ko na siya, no? Nilaga ko na siya ng a few minutes until it's tender na. That tender, you just season it with water, boiled in salted water, and strained. Yan, tatabi natin yan. Yung gagawin ko dito, to be able to get more flavor out of this is, I'm just going to pound the heads. Pound it, no? Kunin natin yung katas ng ulo, and add a little water, around 2 to 3 tablespoons of water, and we will add this pag ginisa natin to. So, ito yung magiging, added flavor natin. Okay, I'll put that aside for the moment. And I'll begin to saute. Yan. Yung saute ko, I will just saute onions. Wala na siyang garlic. Kung bakit walang garlic, di ba? Usually may garlic. because the sauce has loads of garlic. So para hindi siya redundant, onions na lang kailangan natin dito. I will just saute the onions until tender. And I will add my giniling from Fresh Options. Yan. Pork giniling. You can also use chicken giniling. You can also have no giniling at all. You can make it entirely vegetarian. I will also saute my shrimp. So, mga kalahating cup ng, you know, shrimp na chinap-chop natin na parang giniling din yung texture. And I season with dato puti patis para mas maging malinamnam yung aking feeling. And black pepper, UFC black pepper. Yan. And I will add my ubod. Alam natin yung ubod will not take long to cook anymore because malambot na siya, no? So we took the step earlier na nilaga na natin siya. And we will add our ubod. Yan. So if you don't have ubod, you can use a mixture of singkamas and radish as well. So, very classic na old-fashioned na recipe. Yan, gisa tayo. And of course, bago ko makalimutan, para makuha talaga natin yung shrimp flavor, yung ating shrimp heads natin dito. Malinamnam, undoubtedly, shrimp flavor ang nasa palaman ng ating lumpiang ubod. And we just let that simmer until the juices reduce and hindi na masyadong watery yung ating lumpiang ubod, yung palaman natin. In the meantime, of course, anong kulang natin? Meron na tayong crepe, meron na tayong palaman. Ang sauce na lang kulang natin, kaya gagawin na rin natin yung ating sauce. So I will just combine para madali mo ma-dissolve yung inyong cornstarch. So, cornstarch and sugar, di ba matamis-tamis? Yung gagawin mo lang dito, just combine the cornstarch and the sugar para iwas lumps na to. Mix that. Put it there. Together. Once na-separate na yan lahat, when we add the water, hindi na tayo mahirapan sa lumps. Yan, just twist that, no? Breaks all the starch. Sobrang bilis lang ng ating sauce. Half a cup of Silver Swan soy sauce. Yan, to give it that brown color. And lalagyan din natin ng oyster sauce. Around a tablespoon of dato puti oyster sauce. Masarap. Stir that together. And ito para sa nutty flavor. Peanut butter. So around a tablespoon or two of the peanut butter. Yan. Hindi mo masyadong halata na may peanut butter. But you know, it adds that very nice flavor. Actually, luto na yung aking filling. Everything has come together. Yan. And itatabi ko lang tong aking ubod para mag-cool down before we start, you know, assembling our lumpia. So, our sauce is already thick. Look at that. Ganda ng ating sauce. And look at that. Our sauce is already thick and very smooth to finish. Ito lang yung dadagdag ko. I'm adding 2 tablespoons of milk. You can use evaporated milk or pwede ding fresh milk. And just to lighten up the color and give it a very nice creaminess. And of course, 4 tablespoons of garlic. Oh, minced garlic. Ito yung gusto natin. Pero once we add the garlic, we turn off the fire again. We don't want to overcook the garlic kasi you still want that, you know, slight sharpness of the garlic. And it's done. Tapos na yung ating sauce. And we're ready to wrap. So, look at that. My wrappers are done. And as it cools down, yung crepes natin, nagiging mas matibay siya. So, it's easier to handle. Look at that because nilagyan natin ng, you know, paper dito na guide. Sobrang dalit natin ma-separate yung pieces. You know, of course, may lettuce leaf ako. Diba ganun yung talaga pag fresh lumpia? Masarap siya pag medyo mataba siya, diba? Look at that, hindi siya mahirap i-handle kasi matibay yung ating wrapper. Wow, di ba? And meron na tayong lumpia. So look at that, nakagawa tayo ating lumpiang sariwa. Isipin mo lang, 3 simple recipes to make one dish. So yung recipe natin ng crepe, yung recipe natin ng palaman, at yung recipe natin ng sauce. So here it is, our version of lumpiang sariwa a la simple. Kaya niyo itong gawin, kaya tandaan niyo, kahit sino kaya magluto, basta simple! Mga simple, remember, loving is sharing. Kaya share this video and like niyo na rin. Kain mo na ako. Bye!